I think it's amazing. Her performance is so natural. In the film, it almost looks like there's no camera in front of her. But most of the time, your camera is quite close to the characters. And it's a 35mm camera, so it's quite large as well. How did you do it?
It wasn't just all. It wasn't just me. It was the fact that we actually really took our time with casting, and Brooklyn was a find. And we made sure we didn't even want to go into production until we found the perfect Mooney. And Brooklyn had come with previous experience. She did. She's from the Orlando area. She had done a few commercials and an independent. So she already, and her mother was an acting coach herself. So she came with that experience. She took it to a whole, she won us over within seconds in the audition, but we knew that she wore her emotions on her sleeve. She was a very expressive young girl, very funny, very, very energetic and witty. And so we knew she probably had the potential to go to those places, like the final scene where she was crying. But we didn't know it was going to be that wonderful, quite honestly. We didn't know she was going to take it to that level. That scene was shot a week and a half into production because we had to shoot out of order because of budgetary reasons. And that day was a big day for all of us because she came to set that morning and she said, "I'm ready. I've been talking to my mother and I'm ready to cry." And you know, she was preparing, you know, we had a month of rehearsals, and every day, you know, we had workshops and everything, and to get the kids to where they had to get to, but we never went over that scene, because we didn't want to. You don't rehearse a scene like that, because if you might kill it, meaning the actor may be able to get there in the rehearsal, and then you never are able to get that again, and then you would just want to... You wouldn't be able to live with yourself. So you keep a scene like that for the day of. And she came and said, "I'm ready to cry. I've been thinking about what it would be like if I could never see my best friend again." And that was a moment where I thought, oh my gosh, she's now thinking about the character's motivations and where the character is. We didn't have to, and we weren't even going to go there, but we didn't want to, you know, manipulate her in terms of, you know, think about the saddest day in your life, or think about your dog who died, or something. You know, we didn't want to do that. We wanted just to, because we just didn't feel right to do that for a child of this age. So we just wanted her to get there herself, and she did, and we couldn't believe it. We had the camera set up. Am I being too long-winded?
No, please.
I can wrap it up a little. I can be a little. I'll bridge a bit. So, but basically, we were behind the camera, and Samantha Kwan, who is the acting coach on the film, and Alexis Abe, they're right next to me, and we're just all holding each other's hands because of how it was moving us on the set. And I rarely get emotional on my own sets, but it was hard not to be moved by this girl's performance. And then I yelled cut, and the entire crew came over and hugged her, she called her mother because her mother wasn't on set that day, and she said, "Mr. Sean said I did good," and I said, "You did a lot better than good," and we did one take, and I didn't want to put her through it again, but so I actually was getting a wide shot that didn't even make it into the movie.
Oh.
It was a wide shot just for coverage sake. From the side, and I said, "Brooklyn, you've already done a perfect job. You don't. This time, the camera's on your back, so we don't even see your face. You don't have to cry again. Just pretend you're crying." And I yelled action, and suddenly I was looking closely at the monitor, and I'm seeing their tears again. I'm like, "Oh my God, she's doing it again." So it just shows how incredible she is. She's like literally one of the best dramatic actors I've worked with of any age.
Such natural talents.
Yeah.
And I think you must have made them bond, like make the whole crew and team bonded.
Yeah, we were a nice family unit. Again, Samantha Kwan became very maternal in a way with them. She was the acting coach. And then these two, the two girls, became like best friends. And they remain best friends. That's the wonderful thing.
Wonderful.
So, yeah, that was a true bond on set.
One last question from me, and we'll open it to the audience. Who has seen Tangerine, by the way? His previous, yeah, quite a lot. Thank you.